Damn, pussy, you a cripple. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Matchup of the Week. First of all, we'll take a look at, we'll just kind of determine who's not going to be Matchup of the Week. Obviously, it's not going to be Toxic and J-Bay because Toxic's going to beat down J-Bay. It's actually going to be myself against Big Yawners. He's going to play Joe Burrow and Tyler Boyd. I'm going to use Jamar Chase and T. Higgins. Yeah, no, not really. But either way, I think even if we both play our starters, I don't think that'll be matchup of the week worthy. I do think that it's going to be a significantly bigger gap unless there's an upset in that specific game. Then you have the battle of the lovebirds between Evan Trone and Mr. Steeler Girl. I don't know if I can say for sure that Steeler Girl wins. This is kind of a coin flip. As it stands, I think I'm leaning towards Steeler Girl winning, but he is missing a few key pieces that might keep it close. That's definitely an important game, but I don't think it'll be too good of a game just because I do think both of these teams are going to be struggling this week. You should have a pretty good matchup with Rictatorship and Booty Basher, especially if Booty sets his team. Unfortunately, I don't think Booty's going to end up setting his team. He hasn't done it in a few weeks, but that would be a pretty good matchup if they did set their teams. That should be a pretty high-scoring one. You have MILF, who might pull off an upset against B-Dog. That would be fucking beautiful if he pulls it off. But no, in all reality, the matchup of the week is, of course, going to be Karen's husband and pussy. I told you guys in a video before, I'm not going to pass up the opportunity to put some of the top three teams against each other, you know what I mean? Or some of the most winning teams against each other for the matchup of the week. So we're going to get right into it. It's going to be Karen's husband and pussy. I especially do think this will be matchup of the week, not just because it's going to be important when it comes to the final standings, because Karen's husband is actually going to be fighting to hold their division title this week since they lost and everybody else is at four wins now. I guess I'll show you the standings and everything just so you guys can get a picture of everything. Pussy is a few games up, so he's not going to be needing this win as much, but Karen's going to be fighting hard here because, yeah, everyone in their division is now fighting for that title. So Karen's husband, if they lose, they could slip on the division title at least for now. But if they win, they hold it at least for another week. Either way, this is a very important matchup for Karen. 1-3 should be a pretty good one. Before we even kick things off, both are missing some crucial pieces here. Karen's going to be missing Josh Dobbs because Josh Dobbs just got traded to Minnesota for this. So for this specific week, Josh Dobbs isn't going to be able to play for Karen's husband. But on the flip side, Pussy is going to be losing Kirk Cousins, who just got sent to IR for the rest of the season. So they each have a pretty decent piece missing already. Pussy also is going to be having Russell Wilson, who's going to be out for this specific game. Travis Etienne, James Conner. Quite a few significant losses here, especially on Pussy's side of things. You also have Nick Bosa on a bye week. Now it's worth mentioning Karen's husband is going to be out. Zach Ertz, who's on injured reserve, he's going to be out. Alex Anzalone and Grover Stewart. But I don't think these guys are nearly as significant as the amount that Pussy is going to be losing out on this week. So if there's any week for Karen's husband to take down Pussy, this is the ideal chance for Karen's husband. And either way, yeah, this is definitely going to be a pretty good matchup, I think, and pretty important and pretty close, actually, like I said. But either way, let's get right into it with the quarterback part of things. Whenever we were doing the rankings with me and Pussy, we had Karen's husband ranked at 12th and at 8th, which averages him at 10th. And then Pussy was ranked at 6th and 7th, so he was averaged at 6.5. Now, this was before Pussy lost Kirk Cousins. And yeah, these quarterbacks are looking quite a bit different than they looked like whenever we were making those rankings. But the current matchup looks like Lamar Jackson and Zach Wilson taking on Will Levis and Geno Smith. First of all, Lamar Jackson against Geno Smith is a mismatch. You don't put Lamar Jackson in an ISO against Geno Smith. Lamar Jackson's probably going to outscore him. Now, Lamar Jackson does have those games where he plays like shit. But overall, I do still think he'll probably outscore Geno Smith. Geno Smith has had a peak of, let's say, 27 points in a game so far this season, and it was a game where he threw a bunch of touchdowns to make up for it, if I'm not mistaken. Well, two, but either way, I definitely think Lamar is a big advantage over Geno Smith. And here's where we see a big question mark, because Zach Wilson is undisputedly ass. You're not going to get an argument out of me out of that. I hate the motherfucker. He looks like Johnny Test. But either way, he's just not doing anything good this season. I'd say he's kind of comparable to Geno Smith, just a lot worse and a lot less consistent. And I can't really see any upside with him. Now, Will Levis, I can't tell you what's going to happen with Will Levis. He went in there for the one game against Atlanta and fucking cooked up. 4 touchdowns, no interceptions, looked fantastic. And I want to say he's going to do that again. I'd love to. But it's hard to say for sure because they are still using one of the worst O-lines in all of football. And they are playing against the Steelers, who will be having one of the best D-lines in all of football. So it's very hard for me to sit here and say, yeah, Will Levis is going to go out there and have a great game again. Because I honestly don't think he will. It's kind of a situation where I think he's designed to fail here. And going into this Thursday night football game, I don't see either of them doing too good this week. So I do think in terms of the quarterback game for this specific week, I think I'm actually leaning in the favor of Karen's husband overall, just because Lamar Jackson does have that higher upside. Then we'll look at the running back room. Pussy was ranked at 4 and 3, and then Karen's husband was ranked at 9th and 6th, which averages 7.5. So we'll look at what they have offering for this week. First of all, it's Tony Pollard on the side of Karen's husband. Tony Pollard has been so fucking inconsistent over these past few weeks, but if he can get back to what he did in the first few weeks, this should be pretty good. He's going against the Eagles, who are very tough against the run. I do think the Cowboys are going to end up passing the ball a lot more in this game, which could be good if they use him for checkdowns, but if they don't, it's going to be a struggle because I don't think he's going to get much going in the running game. He really hasn't all season. Karen's husband also has Alex Mattison, and I'm losing faith in Alex Mattison over the past 3 weeks since they've gotten Cam Akers. He's been progressively doing worse and worse. Now, at least he's still getting a lot of snaps, for what it's worth, but Cam Akers is directly taking half of them, and now his touchdown upside is probably going to be in the toilet with the absence of Kirk Cousins, but we'll have to wait and see. Pussy has Josh Jacobs, who's pretty much in the same situation as Alex Mattison, except Josh Jacobs is actually good at football. He's not going to have any touchdown upside. Well, he might if he gets really lucky, but it's going to be hard to sit here and trust. Where he's going to be having Adam O'Connell as his quarterback, and I just overall cannot trust this guy, to be honest. I think Pussy definitely has a good player in James and Josh Jacobs, but it's so hard to trust the guy with that offense overall, like I said. Then you also have Brian Robinson, if you're Pussy, who's had a consistent around 7 to 10 points per game pretty much all season. He's been consistently okay. Overall, at least you're getting consistency. I definitely think at this point in time, I'd prefer Brian Robinson over Alex Mattison in fantasy. But that's about as far as I can go. I do think in terms of the running back matchup, not counting the flexes or bench options, I definitely think I'm leaning towards Pussy here in this specific contest by quite a bit, unless Tony Pollard gets really lucky and starts getting a lot of checkdowns, but I don't think it'll happen. Then we'll look at wide receivers. Pussy was ranked at 2, Karen's husband was ranked at 6th and 4th, so an average of 5th. First of all, you have an elite matchup between Stephon Diggs and Tyreek Hill. Now, you got a good, I don't know, let's say 50-50 of what's going to happen here. Stephon Diggs, you know he's going to get 15-plus points. It's clockwork, you know it's going to happen. He could get, you know, he could get lucky and have one of those 20-plus point games. But you know he's going to be consistent on pretty much every game. Tyreek Hill has like a 30% chance or so to just not do well. Well, he'll still have a good 10 points per game. He'll probably still have a good, say, 20 points, actually. Either way, I do think Tyreek Hill is going to have a better match over the week or for this specific week, especially going against Kansas City. Kansas City has a really good run defense overall for this season, although they are missing Nick Bolton, so that might be a little bit deflated for now. But either way, I definitely think Tyreek Hill is going to be the better guy than Stephon Diggs here, just because of how ridiculous Hill has been so far this season. But Hill definitely does have the tougher matchup here than Stephon Diggs. Stephon Diggs is probably going to cook up against the Bengals, if I had to guess. I'm guessing at least 20 points, because, yeah, the Bengals are having a cornerback one return from an injury, and that usually doesn't go too well with Chidobe Awuzie. And then you look at Chris Olave against Keenan Allen. I do think this is a very big mismatch in favor of Pussy. Chris Olave has his occasional weeks of upside, but Yeah, it's just he doesn't really have anything insane when it comes to that upside. He had the 1 week where he had 20 points, and since then he's had less every single week, sometimes having even worse weeks than that. You know, he's consistently solid. He does have around 15-point upside, but I just don't think it compares to Keenan Allen. Keenan Allen's been one of the top options in all of fantasy when it came to wide receiver. He has significantly dropped off since the absence of Mike Williams, but he's still better than Chris Olave almost around the board. He can probably be promised more consistency and a lot higher upside. So overall, I do think the wide receiver group, at least in terms of the not the flexes, is a significant advantage in terms of pussy. And then we'll look at the flexes next. You got Terry McLaurin on the side of Karen's husband, who I do think has been fluking over the past few weeks. What I mean by that is I don't think he's going to do as good as he's done the last 3 weeks against the Patriots. I think this will be a low-scoring game, even with the absence of Curtis Samuel being a possibility. I think that'll more benefit Jahan Dotson. But either way, I do think this is going to be a low-scoring game or run-heavy game, which I think is actually going to help Pussy out. Pussy does have Jakobi Meyers, who, honestly, if I'm Pussy, I don't know how to even rank this, because in theory, he's a great running back, but he just doesn't have... anybody on this offense just doesn't have the upside right now, because they're not going to be able to put up fucking points. Now, they are going against the Giants, which is about as good of a matchup as you can ask for whatever that's worth, but it's just so hard to rank Jakobi Meyers. I think I'm going to lean towards Terry McLaurin and having the favor there, even though Meyers has outscored McLaurin almost every week this season. You're going to kind of hope for, if you're Pussy, you're going to be hoping for the Raiders to be losing by like 3 scores by halftime. Then you have Karen's husband, who has Nico Collins. Nico Collins has been inconsistent as hell this season, but if he's able to have one of those blow-up games against a pretty favorable matchup against Tampa Bay, then yeah, this will be a huge advantage for Karen. The problem is his consistency is just not there. Pussy did have some solid news over this past week where Rashee Rice got named to the wide receiver one. Now we'll have to see how that goes, because that is a double-edged sword when you're Pussy. On one hand, that means that you're probably going to be getting more opportunities with Rashee Rice. On the other hand, you're playing against Miami with Rashee Rice, who's going to be going against Jalen Ramsey more often than not, if I had to guess. Usually Jalen Ramsey tries to take out number one receivers that he can lock up. Now, am I saying for sure Rashee Rice would lose that matchup? I don't know, because I've never seen him play Jalen Ramsey, but I would guess because of how good Jalen Ramsey has been in the past. But either way, it's not too good of a matchup for Rice, I don't think, unless he gets lucky and Ramsey takes someone else. But either way, I do think the consistency overall when it comes to this offense is in the side of Pussy. And I do think Karen's husband has a lot more upside overall, though. And then we'll look at the tight ends. Pussy was ranked at 11th and 9th, so averaging 10th. Karen was ranked at 11th and 8th, averaging 9.5. And this was back whenever Pussy had Kyle Pitts instead of Dalton Kincaid. I do think Kincaid's looking like a better option now. He's consistently put up 17.5 points over the past 2 weeks, whether it was with a touchdown or whether it was with more catches and more yards. Either way, both stat lines are pretty good. I don't know for sure if he'll be able to do this every week. I couldn't tell you, but for the weeks we've seen him without Dawson Knox, he's been able to do it, so power to him. There's no reason to suggest he can't do it again, that's for sure. Karen's husband will be using Cole Kmet. Cole Kmet, I'm not going to lie, I don't like this matchup if you're Karen's husband. Cole Kmet's going to be covered by DeMario Davis, one of the better coverage linebackers in the entire league against tight ends. And he's going to be using Tyson Badgett, who's passing the ball to him. And it's kind of a Jakobi Meyers situation where, sure, he had a good week against the Chargers, but a lot of those catches were from garbage time. So overall, I do think it's a similar situation. And I'm definitely preferring Dalton Kincaid here when it comes to the tight end here. So overall, as to recap it all, I pretty much prefer Pussy's offense for the most part outside of the quarterbacks, but I do think Karen's husband, if they have a blow-up week, will run away with the game. But either way, I do think Pussy's going for consistency in this week, at least based off of what I'm seeing. Then in the kicking room, we had Pussy, who is ranked at 7th. We had Karen, who is ranked at 6th and 5.5. So overall, these are close kickers. We have Dustin Hopkins, who's actually the number one kicker in the league. Pussy picked him up in one of the past weeks, who's been pretty damn good. He might be seeing the return of Deshaun Watson soon. But Either way, I do think this is a pretty damn good kicker option, one of the best you could have overall. And yeah, there's really not many better options you can have out there. You had a bad week against the Ravens, but I'd say that was more of a fluke. Karen's husband had Tyler Bass, who hasn't been good for 4 weeks now. He had a few weeks where he was actually missing kicks. So overall, I'm really not looking too excited about Tyler Bass. Not yet. I do think he always has those 16-point game upsides. But either way, I do think the same upside is with Quissy's kicker. On top of that, he also has more consistency. So I'm definitely leaning towards Pussy when it comes to the kicking game as well. Then you have the team defense. This is where I'm severely in favor of Karen's husband. I know Kansas City's defense has looked pretty solid this season, but they are going to be out Nick Bolton, and they are going to be going against the Miami Dolphins, second best offense in the entire league. You do have Tyreek Hill, who's going to be actively going against you, so every time Tyreek Hill does something good, you're going to be hurting from it from your team defense. But either way, I just don't think the Chiefs' defense is going to do that well this week against the Dolphins. I do think the Dolphins are going to put up a lot of points against the Chiefs. It's just a very good matchup for them overall. But either way, I do think the Saints have a much more favorable matchup against the Bears, where they're playing against Tyson Bagent, the Lord and Savior himself. They're playing a very beat-up Bears offensive line, too. The Saints will probably get quite a few sacks. They'll probably make Bagent throw a few mistakes. I do think the Saints will have a pretty good week against the Bears. This is one of their most favorable matchups since the beginning of the season, that's for sure. Yeah, this is just a very beat-up Bears squad. I think the Saints will outplay the Kansas City defense pretty significantly this week, and I do think this is where Karen will severely come back when it comes to all that offensive side of things where I was saying Pussy seemed like he was a lot better. Then we'll look at the DB. Pussy was ranked at 5, Karen at 9. Now, Karen has made some moves. He has Jesse Bates and Jordan Poyer right now. Pussy has Dax Hill and Josh Metellus. Jordan Poyer has looked pretty good over these past couple weeks, but he's been very inconsistent all year, to say the least. He did get hurt at the partial point of the season, so that's worth mentioning. But either way, he's looked solid over these past few weeks. Jesse Bates has insanely good upside, but he hasn't hit it since week 4. I did notice that whenever he got a lot of points in fantasy, it was whenever the other team was trying to pass deep balls. So, for example, this specific week, they're going against Minnesota, who has Josh Dobbs. Or, actually, they're going to be using another backup. I don't think Josh Dobbs is getting the start yet. I don't think Jesse Bates will have one of those, like, 20-point weeks. Because, like I said, in all the weeks they've played against teams that go deep with the ball a lot are the weeks where he did good, and he's been okay since then, but I don't think this will be one of those blow-up weeks, but it's very hard to predict overall. And then Pussy has Dax Hill, I think is one of, if not the best safety option in all of fantasy football. Maybe Cameron Bynum, but either way, this guy is looking fantastic. He gets tackles, he gets sacks, he gets interceptions. This guy's finding a way to pretty much do everything. He's basically the new Jesse Bates for Cincinnati, and he's looking very good overall. Bengals fans are looking very happy about him. Yeah, this is a very good option in fantasy. Now, you'd hope for... There is one concern, and that's that two of the last 3 weeks, he has put up less than 10 points. That's a little bit of a concern, but I do think he'll go back to normal soon. Pussy's also going to be playing Josh Metellus, who, on the flip side of Dax Hill, has actually been peaking over the past two of the past 3 weeks, where he's had over 20 points in two of them. He had a sack in one of the games. He had an interception in the other. He had a forced fumble in the game with a sack. He's getting a lot of tackles pretty much every game, at least 5. This is what you want to see out of your safety. He should have a lot of consistency. His lowest amount of points all season was 7, but he still had a total of 5 tackles, which is still a pretty solid stat line. So I do definitely think, in terms of the DB room alone, I do think I'm leaning towards Pussy here and having a pretty good advantage. Then we'll take a look at the D-line. Pussy is ranked at 2, Karen at 6. Karen has Christian Wilkins, who's going to be going up against a very tough center in Creed Humphrey in Kansas City. To Christian Wilkins' credit, though, he is looking very good over these past 3 weeks. He's been inconsistent all year overall, but these past 3 weeks have been pretty good for him, for what it is worth. And yeah, I do think this will be a tough matchup, though. It's going to be hard unless the Chiefs are trying to power it up the middle, the run at all. I don't think Christian Wilkins is going to have that good of a week, just because Creed Humphrey is arguably the best center in the league, besides maybe Jason Kelce. But either way, I don't think this will be too good of a matchup. Mike Dana has had a few good weeks, but he's just too inconsistent. I can't tell you if he's going to have a good week or not. He's had quite a few good weeks where he's had sacks. He's had a sack in most of the games so far this season, but overall, he's had those 2-3 games where he just couldn't get over 10 points. So he's definitely looking a bit inconsistent. I can't tell you if you're Karen's husband how good he'll do this week. You're taking a shot with him. But good luck. That's pretty much all I can tell you, because there's really no way to predict if he'll get a sack or not. Pussy's going to have Max Crosby, who, you know, is going to be good for a 20-point game. Like, I can almost promise, if I was a betting man, I would put all my money on the fact that Max Crosby is probably going to get over 20 fantasy points one way or another this week. He's probably going to sack Daniel Jones at least once, if not twice. He's probably going to get quite a few tackles for loss because they're going to be trying to use Saquon Barkley all game. I definitely think this is going to be a monster week for Max Crosby, to say the least. And I wouldn't disbelieve it if Max Crosby outplayed both defensive linemen on Karen's husband's side of the ball. And then Pussy also has Montez Sweat. This is where I'm going to say I'm iffy. For this specific week, he is going to be going up against Ryan Ramczyk, a very good right tackle for the Saints. And this is going to be his first week with the Bears, so I can't tell you if he's going to be very good or not. I can't tell you, to be honest. I think he's in a close situation to Mike Dana. But overall, as the season has been going on, he has been a lot, maybe not a lot more consistent. He did have the two bad games, but he's been a lot better overall. But I will say, if you're Pussy, I am concerned about one thing, and that's the fact that Montez Sweat actually made a lot of his big plays off of using Chase Young, using Jonathan Allen, using Daron Payne to take a lot of the double team coverage away. With him now being the number one defensive end, I don't think he'll necessarily have that same ability and same upside he's been having. I think this is actually going to be more of a Yannick Ngakoue benefit, seeing as he's going to be the second best defensive lineman on that D-line for Chicago. But I guess we can only wait and see. But either way, I definitely think Pussy's defensive line is looking better here. Then we'll go ahead and take a look at the linebackers. Karen's husband was ranked at 9th, Pussy at 3. Karen's husband has Jerome Baker, who had that one really good week against Philadelphia, and other than that, has been inconsistent as all hell. I'm not a fan of him. There's a lot of better options out there. If you're Karen's husband, I'd probably recommend you cut him. And then you also have Caden Ellis, who has had some pretty good upside. He had a few good games with 19.5, 18 points. He's been inconsistent through the middle point of the season, but he has gotten back up to getting 14 points per game. I can't tell you why he was doing that in the middle point of the season. I honestly don't know. But he should have the upside to at least get a good 10 points per game. At least that's what I would hope. So I wouldn't say he's cuttable. I definitely don't like Jerome Baker, though. He's just been too inconsistent overall. Pussy has Patrick Queen, who's basically a Roquan Smith in disguise. Just a little bit less consistent, but does have more upside on a given week, if I had to say so. Yeah, Roquan Smith has about the same upside. But Queen usually hits the higher end points a little bit more, while Roquan Smith hits the more consistent points more. Either way, this is definitely a big advantage for Pussy, because he has yet to have a game where he's had less than 10 points. He's getting a lot of tackles every game. You name it, this guy's doing really good. And CJ Mosley has done fucking great this season as well. Lowest game being 12 points against a team that pretty much only passed. Fantastic player overall. Another huge advantage in the favor of Pussy. And then we'll look at the D spot. We have Bobby Okereke, new addition to Pussy's team from Justin Lake's Kids. Very, very good option overall. He's only had one game where it was less than 13 points, which was week one where he had 12. Other than that, the dude has been fantastic every single week, getting around 10 tackles per game. Dude is ridiculous. It's going to be very hard for Karen's husband to compete against that. Pussy also has Danielle Hunter, who's going up against the not weak Atlanta offensive line. The problem with Atlanta's offensive line is they have a really good center and they have a really good right guard. Their tackles suck, which is exactly what Danielle Hunter's good at going against. He goes against tackles. And so we'll have to see if they double cover him and try to focus on stopping him. But I do think he'll have another pretty good game. He's yet to have a game under 10 points this season, so I think he'll find a way to get to Taylor Heinicke at least once, if I had to guess. Then we'll look at Julian Blackman. If you're Karen, I love Julian Blackman. I think this is a very good defensive back option. If you're Karen, I would recommend trying to find someone off of free agency. And cutting maybe Jerome Baker, you know, cutting one of those defensive, maybe not defensive backs, but just cutting someone that isn't doing good for you. And putting Julian Blackman at your DB spot and putting maybe a linebacker or something like that off of free agency in at your D spot, because you could probably get more points from it. There's definitely better options than some of these guys, because I love Julian Blackman. I don't think he compares to Bobby Okereke, but for the DB spot, he's a very good option. Nick Scott is someone I'm not a fan of. He's had 3 good weeks, and he's just been inconsistent since. I'd say this guy's cuttable. Like, a guy like this, I would say if I were Karen's husband, I'd put Blackman at the DB spot and cut Nick Scott and try to find another guy. I could recommend some if you were interested, but either way, this is looking like a pretty damn good matchup. If I had to guess who I think is going to win, I think I'm leaning towards the favor of Pussy overall, but I do think that Karen does have the upside where if his players decide to hit or all connect, you know what I mean, I definitely could see him winning overall, but it's just a matter of if he can light that spark or if his players can light that spark to actually go through and, you know, have good weeks. But overall, Pussy at the end of the day is just a lot more well-rounded, a lot more well-built as a team overall. There is just one problem I have that I do think really holds Pussy's consistency back, or not consistency, his upside back, and that's his main playmaker, Tyreek Hill, is going to be going actively against his defense. If I were Pussy, if you have someone you could drop, I'd recommend trying to find another defense this week, but if you don't want to drop anyone, that's up to you. But either way, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you guys later.